إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم يغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, in about a week, almost every country on the planet, millions of people are going to celebrate the passing of another year. I got a question. عندي سؤال. What are they celebrating? I need to know. What are they celebrating? Because if I'm not mistaken, the only thing that a passing of a year means is 1 year closer to death, 1 year closer to the grave, 1 year closer to standing before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah ta'ala, he says, اِقْتَرَبَ لِلنَّاسِ حِسَابُهُمْ وَهُمْ فِي غَفْلَةٍ مَعْرِضُونَ, that the judgment for mankind, it comes closer and closer, and they heedlessly turn away. And Allah ta'ala, he said, يَسْتَعْجِلُ بِهَا الَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ بِهَا وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مُشْفِقُونَ مِنْهَا وَيَعْلَمُونَ أَنَّهَا الْحَقِّ, that those who don't believe in the day of judgment, they want to hasten on, they want to hurry up and get here. But those who believe in it, they are terrified of it, and they know that it is surely the truth. I need to know, why does everyone celebrate every year that another year goes by? And we know that it's a year closer to death. Allah Ta'ala, he said, يَا أَيُّهَا الْإِنسَانُ إِنَّكَ كَادِحٌ إِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ كَدْحًا فَمُلَاقِي. O mankind, surely you are racing towards the meeting with your Lord, and you are surely going to meet him. And this is why the Salaf, one of them said, عَجِبًا لِكَوْمٍ أُذِنَ بِرَحِيلٍ وَتَرَحَّلَ أَوَائِلُهُمْ وَهُمْ يَلْعَبُونَ. Said, it's amazing that people hear about death, and people die before them, and people keep playing. This past week, how many Muslims died? I heard about 4 Muslims from around the country that died this past week, and then a brother in Durham, North Carolina, died to complete 5. And we keep on playing. Hassan al-Basri, rahimahullah ta'ala, he said, Ibn Adam, innama anta ayyam, kullama dhahaba ayyam dhahaba ba'duk. He said, O son of Adam, you are nothing but days. Every time a day goes by, part of you has gone by. So why do we take death so lightly? I know why. Allah knows best. Maybe it's because they make death seem so beautiful. If you find someone that has cancer or a terminal illness and they die, they say, well, at least they're not suffering anymore. How do you know? Our mother Aisha, radhiallahu anha, she said to the Messenger of Allah, salawatullahi wa salam alayhi, matat fulana wa starahat. She said, so-and-so, this woman has died. Yani, this woman who was suffering, she was sick. She said, this woman has died, and now she's at ease. Faghadaba Rasulullah, salawatullahi wa salam alayhi, wa qala innama yastarih man dakhal al-jannah. The Messenger of Allah became upset, and he said, the only one that's going to be at ease, the only one that's going to rest, is the one who enters paradise. That's it. and it has been authenticated that the best of mankind, the best of all Allah Ta'ala's creation, that when he was going through the pains of death, he was taking the cover from his face and then covering his face again. And he says, Subhanallah, inna lil maut la sakarat. He says, Subhanallah, verily death has pains, the best of mankind, but we think we about to go in ease. And when that death comes, Yaquan, that people believe they're ready for, they say ready to die. People commit suicide like they're ready to go to the next life. What are the people going to want to do? As Allah Ta'ala says, Hatta idha jaa ahadukum al-maut, qala rabbi irji'un. Until death comes to one of them. And they say, oh my Lord, send me back. Oh my Lord, send me back. And why do they want to go back to this world? Does he want to see his daughter one more time? Does he want to kiss his wife goodbye? Does he want to know who won the Super Bowl? None of the above. Allah Ta'ala tells you why you're going to want to come back. He says, لَعَلِّي أَعْمَلُ صَالِحًا فِيمَا تَرَكْتُ كَلَّا. He says, so I can do some good deeds that I left off. كَلَّا. I mean, it's not going to happen. Nobody's coming back. Qatada, rahimahullah ta'ala, he said, Wallahi, ma tatamanna an yarja ila ahlihi. He said, Wallahi, the person who dies, when that soul, when the angel of death takes that soul and is almost at the throat, and he asks Allah to send him back, Qatada said, Wallahi, he does not want to come back to see his family. He doesn't want to see his wife. He doesn't want to see his relatives. He said, nor does he want to amass the dunya. Nor does he want to fulfill his desires. He said, but he only wants to come back so he can obey Allah Azza wa Jalla. He said, so may Allah have mercy upon the person who does now what the kafir is going to want to do when the angel of death takes his soul. Maybe we're relying on our Facebook followers and Twitter followers to make dua for us. Maybe we're going to be a slacker in this life and just hope that we have enough followers to make dua for us. Sheikh Uthaymeen, alayhi rahmatullah, he said, if you're not worthy of your own dua being accepted, then the dua of anyone else is not going to benefit you. Uthman, radhiallahu anhu, he gave a sermon. And he said, Ibn Adam, i'lam, anna al-malik al-maut alladhi wukila bik. He said, O son of Adam, know that the angel of death who has been entrusted to you ever since you was born, from the day you was on the earth, he's always been going past you and going to someone else. He said, but one day, he's going to go past that other person and he's going to come and get you. He said, so be warned and prepare yourself for it and don't be heedless of him because surely he's not heedless of you. He said, and know, O son of Adam, if you are heedless and you do not prepare yourself, no one else is going to prepare it for you. He said, it is a must that you meet Allah Azza wa Jal. So be warned and take care of it and do not entrust it to anyone else. Wassalam. Maybe we're celebrating. Maybe everyone's going to celebrate and get drunk because they're happy about that 1 year closer to the grave. This grave, the Uthman, radhiallahu anhu, this man who was promised paradise. This man who was promised he was going to be a martyr while he was alive. As been narrated in Ibn Majah. From Hani ibn Uthman, he said, the kana Uthman, idha waqafa ala qabr. He said, Uthman, when he was standing at the grave, he would cry so hard. He would cry so hard, his beard would become wet. And they said to him, when paradise and the fire are mentioned, you don't cry. But when the grave is mentioned, you cry this hard. He said, verily, I heard the messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, say that verily, the grave is the first station of the next life. And whoever is saved from the harshness of the grave, then whatever comes after it is going to be easier. And whoever is not saved from the punishment of the grave, whatever comes after it is going to be harder. Maybe everyone's celebrating the day of judgment. That what Allah Ta'ala says, Kana miqdaruhu khamsina alfa sana, that standing which is going to be 50,000 years. And we all know about the hadith. When the people go for the shafa'ah, when they go to get Adam alayhi salam to intercede to start the judgment. But do you know what happens before that? What is it that causes the people to go to Adam alayhi salam and tell him, go speak on behalf, go speak to your Lord? That is before when the people are raised up to life, before the judgment starts, Allah Ta'ala will gather the first and the last of the people. لِمِقَاتِمْ يَوْمِ الْمَعْلُومِ on a known day. قِيَامًا أَرْبَعِينَ سَنَةً. The people are going to stand for 40 years before they hear anything. 40 years straight. No chair. No water. No break. With their eyes fixed to the heavens, wanting to know what's going to happen. And the people with the sun only 1 mile away from their heads. In sweat according to your sins. And the people are going to want to get the judgment on, even if they go to the fire, just so they can sit down somewhere. Just so they can get this over with. Is that what the people are celebrating? May Allah Ta'ala make us of those people who fear him in this life and make us have an easy standing in the next life. Walhamdulillah wa salatu wa salam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Maybe what has everyone so excited to get their intoxicants and party, maybe it's the idea that we're 1 year closer to having to cross over that bridge that Allah Ta'ala is going to place over hellfire. And Allah Ta'ala said about that, وَإِن مِّنْكُمْ إِلَّا وَرِدُهَا كَانَ عَلَى رَبِّكْ حَتْمًا مَقْضِيَّةً. He said, and there is not one of you, except that he is going to have to cross over it. This is a promise for your Lord that will surely come to pass. And the ulama, they say about this bridge that's over the hellfire, that this is the only way that you can get into paradise is by crossing this bridge. And it's 3,000 years up. 3,000 years across, and the fall is 3,000 years down. And the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, وَبِهِ كَلَالِيبْ مِثْلُ شَوْكَ الْسَعْدَانِ. He said, and upon this bridge are going to be thorns like the thorns of Sa'dan. But look at the justice of Allah Ta'ala. Look at the justice of your Lord. These thorns on this bridge which is thinner than a hair and sharper than a sword, and it has thorns on it. Where do the thorns come from? The thorns come from the individual sins of the person. You make your own thorns. You make your thorns today. Make your thorns today. The sins that we do and we don't repent from, these are going to be the thorns on this bridge. That sins from using interest, fornicating, drugs and intoxicants, backbiting, slander, being slack on the salat, these are your thorns. And how many sins do we have, Ya Ikhwan? How many sins do we have? The Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, إن المؤمن يرى ذنوبه كأنه في أصل الجبل يخاف أن يقع عليه. He said, verily, the believer, he sees his sins as though he's at the foot of a mountain and these sins are about to fall on his head. But the evil person, he sees his sins like there's a fly upon his nose, he can swat it away. How do we see our sins, Ya Ikhwan? Imam al-Bukhari, rahimahullah ta'ala, do you know how he saw his sins? Imam al-Bukhari, the Imam of the Hadith, al-Bukhari, he had a student, Abu Ma'shar al-Darir, who was blind. And he went to his student one day and he said, Ya Abu Ma'shar, please forgive me. Pardon me. And he said, what did you do? And he said, one day, I was narrating a hadith, and this hadith amazed you so much that you begin to shake your head and move your hands. فَتَبَسَّمْتُ مِنْ ذَلِكَ. And so I smiled. That's it. Don't wait for nothing else. That's it. He smiled, and he was afraid, as Sheikh Al-Islam said, he was afraid that that smile would be written in his scale of bad deeds because the man didn't know he smiled. So he apologized for that. How much have we apologized for? How many sins have we done? Have we apologized for our sins? And maybe it's because we've done so many sins we've forgotten about them. Ibn Sirin, alayhi rahmatullah, he earned a debt and this debt caused him sadness. And he said, verily, I know why the reason I have this sadness is because of a sin that I did a couple of 40 years ago. It's for something I did 40 years ago. They would be precise in trying to count all their sins and try to get rid of them before they meet the Lord Azza wa Jalla. Maybe the people are celebrating the hellfire. There's a hadith that has been authenticated by Sheikh Albani that he said, the hadith of Abdullah ibn Amr ibn Aus, he said that the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that he came out to us, wa fi yadihi kitaban, and he had two books in his hands. Listen to this hadith, ya Quran wa Qalat. Listen to this hadith. He came out to the companions and he had two books in his hands. And he said, do you know what these two books are? And they said, oh, no, Messenger of Allah, unless you tell us what they are. He said, لِلَّذِي فِي يَدِهِ الْيُمْنَى هَذَا كِتَابٌ مِنْ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ فِي أَسْمَاءِ أَهْلِ الْجَنَّةِ وَأَسْمَاءِ أَبَائِهِمْ وَكَبَائِلِهِمْ. He said, this book in the right hand, it has the names of all the inhabitants of paradise, along with the names of their fathers and their tribes. He said, this book has been sealed, and it's not going to add one name or take one name away. He said, this book in my left hand, it has all the names of the inhabitants of the hellfire, and the names of their fathers, and the names of their tribes, and it's not going to decrease one name or increase one name. How can people celebrate, and you don't know what book your name is in? Everybody sitting here, your name is in a book and it's sealed up. And whatever book it is, it ain't never coming out. People gonna celebrate about that? They said, oh, Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, should we still work and the matter has been decided? He said, work and draw close to Allah. Because verily, those people who are written in the book for paradise, regardless of what action they do, they're going to be sealed with the action of paradise. And those people in the book of the hellfire, regardless of what they do, they're going to be sealed with the action of the hellfire. Who can celebrate? And Ya Quran, we're going to end with this ayat that even our children have memorized. It's in Juz Amma. Maybe it will be an argument against us. May Allah Ta'ala make an argument for us. Allah Ta'ala, he said, لَابِثِينَ فِيهَا أَحْقَابًا. They shall remain therein for ages. They shall remain there for ages. أَحْقَاب is a plural of hukub, an age. Do you know how long an age is? Ali ibn Abi Talib, he knew. The hadith from Sufyan al-Thawri, that they asked Ali ibn Abi Talib, they said, how long is an age? Allah Ta'ala said, they shall remain there for ages. They want to know, how long is one age? He said, this is 80 years. And each year has 12 months. And each month has 30 days. And each day, ka'alfa sinatin kamma ta'uddu. Each day is 1,000 years as you count. That's over 29 million years of torture, give or take a few 100,000. That's not the hard part. That's not the hard part. The hard part, Yaqwam al-Akhawat, is that Imam al-Qurtubi, he said, do you know who this is applying to? This 29 million years, do you know who this is applying to? He said, the kuffar, they never coming out of hellfire. He said, this is for the Muslims who will one day get out. This is for the Muslims who will one day get out of the hellfire. Why are people celebrating? Why are people so happy? Not only could with the Salaf not celebrate, they couldn't even sleep. As Malik ibn Dinar, he said that Qalat ibn Atu Rabi' al Rabi', that the daughter of Rabi' said to her father, oh my dear father, Lima la tanam, why don't you go to sleep? Everybody else is asleep. He said, he said, the fire won't let me go to sleep. The hellfire won't let me go to sleep. What are we going to do, Yaquan? What are we going to do? The solution is to repent to Allah Azza wa Jal. To repent. And don't let anything take you off this religion. This deen is the haq. Don't let anything take you off this religion. If you backslide, slide back on. You fall off, fall back on. They said to Ali ibn Abi Talib, they said, a man commits a sin. A woman commits a sin. What should they do? He said, seek Allah's forgiveness and repent. Qila wa in ad. Said, and what if they sin again? He said, seek Allah's forgiveness and repent. They said, what if he sins again? He said, seek Allah's forgiveness and repent. He said, hatta meta. For how long? He said, hatta shaitan, who are you? Until shaitan is defeated. You keep making tawbah until shaitan get tired. You don't get tired, repent to Allah Ta'ala. You make tawbah till he get tired. Don't leave this deen, because the people that leave this deen are going to the hellfire. Not for ahqab, akhal deen fi abada. The Muslim, sometimes you're going to get a little sad and down. But how can you be depressed? Allah Ta'ala has put you on this path after Islam and Dawah Salafiyah. How can you be depressed? He gave us the best thing of this dunya. Maybe you didn't get money. Maybe you didn't get health. But you got the best thing he's ever given anyone. He gave you what he gave the Anbiya. We're not grateful for this ni'mah. This is the greatest ni'mah Allah Ta'ala has given anyone. Why aren't we overjoyed with this ni'mah? May Allah Ta'ala make us overjoyed with this ni'mah. And keep us upon this ni'mah until we meet him subhanahu wa ta'ala. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين.